BioProfiler is a tool that allows you to access Ingenuity's knowledge base in order to identify a list of genes, proteins, metabolites, or small compounds that meet a very specific criteria. For example, let's say you wanted to identify potential drug targets to treat breast cancer. So you want to first go through the Ingenuity knowledge base to identify a set of genes or proteins that at some point in literature were shown that when they had a decrease in activity, were also associated with a decrease in the breast cancer phenotype. The way you would do this with BioProfiler is that you would come to IPA and you would type in breast cancer as the term or disease that you're interested in. So selecting breast cancer and tumors here, what we see here is that there are 2,383 molecules that are already associated with breast cancer and tumors according to the Ingenuity knowledge base. To see that list of 2,400 molecules, we can expand here. So selecting the checkbox here, we're going to choose all these 2,400 molecules and open them up in BioProfiler. What is returned to us is that list of nearly 2,400 molecules in a sortable and filterable table, where each row is one of the molecules and each column is a different criteria that that molecule can then be filtered on based on its behavior in the literature. For example, here we only want to keep those molecules where there is at least one finding in the knowledge base that shows that when that molecule was decreased in activity, its effect was to have a decrease in the breast cancer phenotype. So of these 2,400 molecules, we're only going to keep those where there is at least one finding where the molecule was decreased in activity. Then of those, we're only going to keep those where when it was decreased in activity, the effect on breast cancer was that the breast cancer was decreased. We have now whittled our list of nearly 2,400 molecules down to just a list of a very practical 26 molecules, all of which in at least one finding were shown that when they were decreased in activity were associated with a decrease in the breast cancer phenotype. And then we also have a hyperlink to all of the findings in which that was true. In addition to the two filters that we showed here, we could have also filtered on a whole nother set of filters, all of which are documented in the help section. For example, we could have kept only those molecules which have already been applied as biomarkers for breast cancer in a specific capacity. Or we could have only kept those that are already known drug targets for drugs in a certain phase of trial. The disease or function filter allows us to add additional terms with which to whittle this list of molecules down further. For example, we may only want to keep of these 26 molecules, those that have been shown to affect a decrease in breast cancer as well as a decrease in metastasis. So we come here and we search for the term metastasis. Finding metastasis in the knowledge base, we select metastasis. And I now move that term to the right-hand side here and select an AND relationship with breast cancer. When I hit apply, the only molecules left in the table are those seven molecules where in at least one finding, their decreased activity was associated with a decrease in breast cancer as well as metastasis. This table can now be exported as a text format or the molecules can be displayed in an IPA network viewer for further analysis.